We were driving once by car victory in the last stage of exhaustion, slow, shaking, dusty Vita. The Shopland Shepherd that we took with us stuck out her tongue and breathed with the last of her strength. I didn't want to spend the night in an open field. And then we saw a hut right by the road. We were delighted. The owners came out to meet us. We let's ask for it. Well, we asked for it, although the owners immediately seemed somehow strange. A common table was set, vodka, a snack. The owners' eyes are dull, lost.
Well, after a couple of drinks, I asked the owner what did happened. I can help with what I need. He fidgeted, and told a horror story that once there was a quite prosperous family in this house, a beautiful wife, but her husband became a cripple, frostbitten his feet, he remained on wooden stumps.
The wife began to walk, but in the end she and her young lover killed her crippled husband, and they took the corpse to the forest. There they threw it to the forest animals. Since then, this dead man began to come to this hut from the forest. He walks around the house, knocks with his wooden legs, and everyone who is in the house is experiencing incredible horror. I still didn't understand. Is he telling me about himself? He has a beautiful wife, children, a decent hut, and he is like an inanimate person at all. Well, it was felt there is no peace in this family. Well, I did not specify anything. I decided to go to bed, and then suddenly my shepherd howls. I've never heard my dog howl, for the first time in my life, an absolutely terrible howl. We looked at each other and then we heard the clatter of wooden prostheses. First in the distance, almost out of the forest, then closer and closer. My blood froze in my veins. The footsteps were almost there, and then there was a knock on the window, followed by some obscene muttering. I never considered myself a coward. But it was beyond my consciousness. I could no longer control myself. The doors creaked and everything.
I don't remember anything further at all. All of us who were in the Victory and tried to settle down for the night in a hut that came along the way, came to our senses under a clear sky, lying somewhere around Kaas.
There was no one else around, and there was no sign of that ill-fated house either, not even a hint of it. Somehow we got to our destination, the village where they were waiting for us yesterday. They told us what happened to us on the way. The old grandfather, who listened to everything, only grinned and, concluding our story, added, when they killed a cripple, he cursed his murderers so that they would not find peace either on the ground or under the ground. And every evening he will comfort them and take them to the next world, and they will die of fear, but they will not die and they will not live. Something in between the living and the dead. That hut has been wandering with them ever since, appears for a short time, then disappears again.
I created the channel quite recently. Please write in the comments what I need to change in the video. Please support me by liking and subscribing to the channel. Thanks.